See you at the crossroad, 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 so you won't be lonely. See you at the crossroad, 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 so you won't be lonely. See you at the crossroad, crossroad, so you won't be lonely. See you at the crossroad, crossroad. Hey.
Hey, man. Rest in peace, Jesus. Jesus. Hey, for those of y'all didn't know Jesus, Jesus was born December 25th, I believe, 1964. We both was born December. I think I was like a year older than Jesus. I think I met Jesus probably in, he was 14, I was like 15 in Cyprus. Jesus was known for hustling. His hustle back then was gambling. He was known for always gambling. And, you know, basically he was good at it. You know, playing CeeLo, 4, 5, 6. See how low your money can go. That was a dice game back then from the people that's on the East Coast, especially right now in New York. That's what we used to do. You know, you're either playing, rolling no dices, man. You're playing no dices, man. 4, 5, 6, CeeLo, man. And right now, he used to be busting people in the head, winning, you know, large sum of money, man. As time go on, you know, we went away from robbery, stealing, you know, you name it, we went away, that little group. But, like, from my understanding, I think Jesus didn't get caught up until, like, years later. But everybody got into, like, 84, 85, 86, 87, 88, 89. Everybody started getting into that drug game, man. Everybody wanted to hustle. Everybody wanted to hustle, you know, the cocaine game, crack, man. Crack, basically, like I say, we destroy our community, but we want to take the easy way out. And by taking the easy way out, not always is the easy way out, because what we're doing is we're not thinking long term, we were thinking short term. So we was polluting our community, open up spot, calling ourselves right now, trying to make fast money. What for? Because once again, we want to be fly. I remember right now when he first got that white, you know what I'm saying, Mercedes Benz, man. He got that big wide body Mercedes Benz. And right now, whereas he had curtains in it. So it was like a big, like I'm saying, 500 series Mercedes-Benz, white, long, you know, with the curtain in it. From my understanding, he's supposed to have got that Benz. He bought it from this Haitian guy named Poe, if I'm not mistaken, or whatever. And like I told you, man, Jesus was doing his thing. He was doing his thing for quite some time. And you know what? Come with that. When you out there and you're doing your things, you're going to bring about jealousy, man. There's a lot of jealousy. There's a lot of hatred or whatever. And like me and Jesus, I don't care what anybody say, we had like this love-hate relationship. Because if he say something, I say something he didn't like, I didn't like, we used to go at it. I'm talking about we used to go at it like cats and dogs. But the crazy thing about that, we used to go at it within that community, within that Cypress Hill, East New York area. But the difference is, like when we on the outside, partying, having a good time, and we together, it's like right now, the same way we come together is the same that we're going to leave together. It was a lot of times, guess what, when we's out and about, and you had these wolves, like hungry individuals, they used to always want to plot and scheme and try to get at them. And what I used to tell them, hold on, wait a minute. I don't care what y'all think y'all might or might don't know about me and Jesus' relationship. The difference is that's my brother. And if he with me, guess what? Y'all ain't doing nothing to him. Because if you're going to do something to him, you got to do something to me. It doesn't matter. It's like right now where you can grow up in the same household. You and your brother, you and your sister can fight all the time. But that's in the house. But then again, you go outside and somebody else trying to do something to your brother and sister, you're not having it. And that's the same thing with me and him. I didn't care. When we was together, nobody under any circumstance could have disrespected him, could have came at him, tried to get on. If you get him, you're going to get me. Otherwise, right now was guess what? That's how we was. Me, him, and L, we used to hang out like crazy, man. I remember one time like I say, both our birthdays in December, man. And I remember December 87, man. You know, right now, I was going to celebrate. I was going to turn 24. So I had on this, like, two-piece Gucci, you know what I'm saying, suit. And right now, like, dressed, you know, have my little gaiters on or whatever. You know, little jewels. So here it is right now with him. You know, he always got to try to be top dog. And he got mass jewelry on. And we went down to the Red Parrot, man. We went down to the Red Parrot, just me and him. We didn't have no crew or anything. But guess what, man? It's like we had a great time, man, celebrating, you know, bringing in my 24th, bringing in his, you know, 33 birthday, 23 birthday. And you know what? Guess what? We had a good time, man. And so to me, like I said, I can remember the last time I saw him, man, at Cypress Day. Cypress Day 2010 He had came home from South Carolina doing some years or whatever. And like I told you right now, we had heart to heart. And like, you know, I had to break it down. Like, I know a lot of people used to think that we was arch enemy. Nah, it was nothing to arch any about us or whatever. It's like when we went at it in a project around the East New York area, we went at it hard. But the difference is when you was with me, I didn't give a damn. You was not going to take a loss under my watch, under any circumstance, because that was love, man. That was family, man. So just like I said right now, man, rest in peace, Jesus. You know, hey, you're going to be loved, missed by a lot of people, man. And like I tell you right now, brother, I don't care. To me, I love you. I respect you. Like I say, you was a good one, man. Like I'm saying, rest, hey, may your family have comfort. And the words that come out of my mouth, man, you know, to your, you know, your wife, your kids, your grandkids, your great-great-grandkids, your brothers and your sister, your niece and your nephew, man, your in-laws, man. Like I said right now, man, hats off, man. Rest in peace to my Cypress brother. Hey, I love, I respect, and right now you will never be forgotten, man. Rest in peace, Jesus. One love. Brian Glaze Gibbs.